Veroli's got his acrobatics, he's got his clever tactics, his twists and turns, and he's fast and he's speedy, but Yannick Borel is Yannick Borel. And as many times as we've seen him, as many times as I've seen him on this podium, yeah, it doesn't matter what you throw at him. He's not gonna relinquish his advantage to anybody. Nice from De Grilli. Persistence pays off. But that's what he's going to have to do, is just go toe to toe with Yannick Borel. Veroli doing all the work. It's Di Veroli doing all the work and Yannick Borel carefully picking his shots and getting them. today. We go to our 1 minute break, four for Yannick Borel, two for Davide Di Veroli, and he is working hard. I was there and I was calling all the matches in the first year that the FIE at the Cadet and Junior World Championships starting grouping the weapons so that epee would be 3 days in a row. And there would be junior epee on day one, cadet epee on day two, and junior team epee on day three. And on day one, cadet Davide Di Veroli got up in the morning, did the pools, and carried on throughout the day and finished the day as junior world champion. 24 hours later, he did the same thing and became cadet world champion. And we were all wondering, how is he still like able to walk after that? Came out on the third day, did the same thing again, and came away with the team bronze. So he is definitely a hard worker. He's definitely physically fit, but it is the economy of effort and the efficiency of that effort, I think, that's going to come into play here. Shoulder. Now, Borel is asking for a video review. That was a furious exchange. Saying that he hit the screen behind. I didn't see that in the replay, but these replays are at kind of odd angles. But if that's what down by three, if that's what Davide Di Veroli has to do to get a hit, he better be in some kind of shape. Okay, but the call stands. Some communication between referee and Borel's coach, former world champion Gauthier Grumier, which is part of this all-star team, along with the returning Hugh Zobry, that's going to take France to the Olympics in Paris in 2024. But I have no idea what they were trying to communicate. I think he's telling. Referee's telling Grumier to sit down, is what he's telling him. And a fair amount of patience paying off for Borel there. pick up the guard. Veroli is just piling in now, and it's becoming easier for Borel to see his opportunities because he knows that Veroli is going to come forward. Borel is just waiting. Go to our second break. And it is all Yannick Borel. Meanwhile, Davide De Veroli is working harder than ever. And I need to stand corrected here. In 2018, Davide De Veroli didn't win the junior title. He won the junior silver medal and then won the gold medal in cadet the next day and then won the bronze in team the day after that. 3 days running. Comes flying in, Borel takes a step back. And bang. Good. see it. This is not a productive hit rate for Davide Di Veroli. Well, he keeps trying and goes up from Burrell. Di Veroli, after that failed attack, turned his back to walk back to the line, and Burrell wanted a card for that. Well, a double will work. Perfect. Burrell picks up that blade and finishes this match. It's a gold medal match for the French, single digits, and bronze for the Italians. I think we're beginning to see, not beginning to see, but we really are beginning to see what a force France is going to be in 2024. And there it is, official. Yannick Borel into the gold medal match, 15-9 for Davide Di Veroli. First gold medal match coming up. Well, it's coming up. It's coming up right now.